intermission. Upon return, you will be seated at the appropriate interval. Thank you and enjoy the show.
Thank you all so much for being here today. It's been an incredible day, just an amazing, amazing amount of heartfelt music performance going on. It's just been incredibly moving. I'd like to just quickly have, and Ed, if you don't mind pulling the house lights up for a second, let's just recognize our student performers for the day. If you'll all stand up, please. Just incredible, incredible music making, and of course, made possible by their incredible teachers. So the percussion instructors, band directors, any of you in the house, please stand up also. Let's recognize them. This day would not be possible without the generous support of the Oregon Center for the Arts, our director here, David Humphrey. I want to thank him from the bottom of my heart for his support of this program, and also the support of our industry sponsors. You can see their names up here at the front: Marimba One, Yamaha, Vic Firth, Zildjian, Remo, and Black Swamp. We're going to have a fantastic raffle at 5 p.m. for the students who perform today. And these companies make all this beautiful gear up here and help to support these kind of educational activities, and we really appreciate them. I want to thank the 17 SOU percussion students who have produced this day with me. If they'd all come out, please. Clockwork. They've all chipped in and helped with every facet of this, from the planning to the production to this performance you're about to witness. So I'm so thankful to them, so proud of their work. Amazing human beings. And a little bit later, I get the joy of introducing to you our guest artist. We've had three fabulous adjudicators today. Well, myself and two fabulous adjudicators. Brian Jeffs, if he's still in the house. Brian, are you still here? I think he had to go. He's directing the Raider Band, which about half of these students are in, and they have two basketball games tonight. After this, all day, which is incredible. So I want to thank Brian, and of course, Ivan Trevino, our guest artist. I'll introduce Ivan to you all in a few minutes when he comes out to play some music for you. We are, I hope everybody got a program for our set here. It somehow got omitted from the main. We're excited to be playing all this music of Ivan's and one other piece by Peter Martin. You're in treat. You're in store for a real treat. This performance, these students are playing so well. So, thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you.
Isn't that a beautiful piece? Incredible. That's written by our good friend Peter Martin, who is a member of Third Coast Percussion, has been here a few times in the last few years. One of our favorite percussion groups from Chicago. And we're a little set change here. The rest of our music will be by none other than Ivan Trevino. Thrilled again to be playing his music today. The comments and thoughts and just the just amazing ideas that we've been hearing from Ivan since yesterday. He arrived, worked with our students yesterday, worked with all the students today, and it's been truly, truly inspiring. He's such an incredible musician. We're hearing his inspiration in the, you know, the performances of these students and their own compositions. We had compositions performed today by high school students who wrote pieces, by our former alumni who are now directing ensembles who have written pieces. It's really, really inspiring, and Ivan's influence on these folks is not to be dismissed at all. So I'm really excited to introduce to you, Ivan wants to say a couple words to you about this next piece you're gonna hear. So please welcome Ivan Trevino.
Thank you so much. I'm so happy to be here. Terry and I have been talking for years about trying to plan a visit, so I'm glad that it's finally here. And it's been a really special day, a really special visit. And I think as a composer, even having one piece performed is really special. So to get a concert that features a lot of my music means a lot. So thank you, Terry. I'd like to talk about this next piece. It's entitled Almaty. And Almaty is a city that I visited in Kazakhstan in 2014, and I've since been back again. And I was actually a music ambassador for the US State Department at the time, so I would travel all around the world using music as a way to build bridges, to connect with people in other cultures, and to share music with each other. It was really great. But honestly, with Kazakhstan, I didn't really know what to expect. And I got to Almaty, and it was amazing. I'm from Austin, and it was a lot like Austin. People supported the arts. It was super trendy. It was like nothing I'd ever experienced. It was like Austin on steroids or something. Maybe like Portland, I don't know. So anyway, I got back from Almaty, and I wrote a poem, just a short little poem about my experience there. And then I wrote this piece afterwards, but I'd like to share the poem with you. I think I have it memorized. Here it is. I found a place that appreciates music for what it is, not what it seems to be or appears to be. I found a place where art prevails over money, where art prevails over subscribers and followers. I found a place that is cold in temperature, but warm in humanity, where people love to be enlightened. I found a place where people dress like hipsters and hug like parents. I found a place that feels pure. Thank you.
Thank you.
segregating my musical interests, I decided to embrace them. And I think that's why my music sounds the way it does. It sort of combines my academic training with my love of normal people music. And in particular, I love songwriting. I have written a ton of songs. I play guitar. I'm not a singer at all. I'm not very good, but I like to sing. I feel like musicians should be able to sing a tune. So I often utilize singing as a way to conceive my pieces. Maybe I'll sing a melodic line, and then I'll figure out how that might work on the marimba. But a few years ago, I decided to take that idea even further. So I decided to actually use the marimba as a singer-songwriter instrument. So I wrote a collection of songs featuring a singing marimbist. And I'd like to play one of those songs for you right now and sing for you, or at least try to. It's called Baila, and it's sung in Spanish. It's dedicated to my mother. She immigrated to the United States when she was 16 or 17, I think. And she really is the American dream story. She grew up with absolutely nothing. And years later, you know, she put me through college and she owns her own business, and it's just pretty amazing. But her Mexican culture was obviously very important to her, but also important that I know about it and learn about it. So every summer, she would take me to Mexico. We would have these big family reunions. There would be like 400 people there, no joke. There was a ton of food and dancing and probably drinks. I remember not being able to speak a lot, telling my mom, like, you know, what, how am I going to learn this? And she says, you're going to learn. That's why we're going. Every year you're going to go, you're going to learn. And luckily I'm fluent now. But this little memory has always stuck with me. One of my aunts wanted to teach me how to dance, and she kind of did. And I'm not very good at that either, but I remember that memory. And this song, Baila, tells a story about my aunt teaching me to dance in Mexico. So I'm gonna go get my mallets because they're over there, but then I'll come back and I'll sing.
Thank you.
Terry's gonna join me and read some poetry, not that I wrote, but that someone else wrote. This poem is entitled Desiderta, and it was written in 1927 by an American writer named Max Ehrmann. And it's sort of a credo for living life. One of my really good friends introduced it to me. And he said, Ivan, I'm not religious at all, as you know. And I said, yes, I know that. And, but he said, this poem maybe is as religious as I'll get. I checked it out, and I fell in love with it. I really think it probably rang true then in 1927, and it rings true today, I think especially, to be quite honest. The last line of the poem reads, strive to be happy. And after reading that and the poem, I decided to compose a piece, a little marimba solo, and I entitled it Strive to be Happy. And recently I've been having the poem read as I perform my piece. So Terry will be reading Desiderata for us tonight. So here it goes.
Listen to
Can we get all the performers from the day on stage really quick, please? Let's take a photo of everybody, everyone who played today. Stay where you are. Never mind. Stay where you are. It looks good.